So, you need to make sure that the dependent and the independent variables are related to each other. Goodness of fit. Here are two least squares regression lines for two different sets of data. This one is a more plausible predictor of costs than this one, because the data is pretty well wrapped around our line. Here the data is spread more, so even though we have a line that's a least squared line, it is not necessarily a great predictor of the future. So that would be goodness of fit. And of course, there could be a correlation without a causality, and if there's not a causality, then prediction is not as good as if there is a causality. Causality means that you'll have better predictive capabilities. So your calculator would come up with a regression line, looks something like that. Looks just like the high-low when you're done, but it will have some other statistics associated with it. It has a concept of R, the R value. The R value in regression analysis. R is some number between negative 1 and 1. Zero is in the middle. The closer you are to negative 1 or 1, the better the fit. The closer you are to 0, the worse the fit. Negative 1 just means it's as your independent variable increases, your dependent variable will decrease. So when you're in the negative range, it's an inverse relationship. One decreases as the other one increases. When you're in the positive range, as most cost functions will be, they increase together. So really, for cost functions, we're looking at this range. 1 means it's a perfect fit. Every point is directly on the line, and that, you know, happens best in physics. 0 means there's no relationship at all. You just drew a line, but it has no predictive ability. So depending upon the closer you get to 1, the better the predictive ability of your regression line. Now, I mean, for costs, negative, you know, I'm not sure, you know, how many how your costs would go down. Your costs go up as some kind of a driver goes down. Maybe you could think of a driver that's like that. It's hard for me to think of one off the top of my head, though. Generally speaking, they're going to go up together in some relationship. So the pros is objective. It's statistically precise. It gives you more information. It just doesn't only give you the line. It tells you how good your line is. You know, they say it's harder in the text, but it's not harder because your calculator can do it for you. It figures it out. It does the least squares math. It also can be influenced by outliers, but not nearly as much as the high-low. Okay. Sorry about the volume.
The
Why did I show that? Because I thought you'd find it funny. And that's an example of a nonlinear function, right? An expected learning curve. They didn't quite get the learning curve, but